What's going on, people? This is Shire Harris of the Rep Society, and this is The Process. The Process is the ultimate entrepreneur and creative tool guide on how to make money, how to really maneuver the wild shit that happens as being an entrepreneur. So, and today, we're going to just talk briefly about three to four tips on how to take your brand from zero to 100 real quick. So once again, The Process is the ultimate entrepreneur tool guide for how to make money, how to generate interest, how to get clients, all that good stuff in between. So like I said before, this episode is centered around how to take your brand from zero to 100 pretty quickly. So first things first, I try to give the most tangible advice possible. So first one is pretty simple, just start. You really have to just start, go out there and just start putting together some type of portfolio of what you're ultimately trying to do. If you're trying to be a, shoot music videos, just find somebody out here that you like their music, just start shooting music videos. It could be the most trashy shit ever, but sooner or later it's gonna get better. If you wanna be in food photography, just get a plate of food, just start shooting it. Then maybe find a local chef who's starting out. See if you can get him to just shoot some his shit. Why am I cussing so much? That's unnecessary. So get him to, you know, be able to shoot some air food and just continue to grow from there. You need to have it set up where when people look at your social media profile, they can kind of see the footsteps of what you're trying to do. If I look at your first 9 pictures on Instagram, it needs to show that these are the things that I'm working on. You can't just have one photo or video of what you're trying to do and then maybe have a photo video of your mom, your baby, your dog, you out getting drunk, like different stuff. It needs to be consistently of what you're looking to do. I really feel like when people check you out, especially when you say, all right, this is what I do. I'm a entrepreneur. I'm a creator. I'm a chef. I'm a writer. When people check you out on social media, they need to see what you claim that you are. The next one is something I feel very strong about. This is where we're gonna get really into the heavy duty stuff. Is that a good term? Yeah, so we're gonna roll with that. So this is where we're about to get into it. To really make your brand stand out, like I said, first, if you already start working on what you're trying to do, then second would be you need to create what I call a WTF moment or what the fuck moment. So you need to create something that looks like anybody that sees this one particular piece of content is completely blown away. A lot of people do that when it comes to videos, having a video that's completely outside of normal, what they're doing or what anybody else is doing, to get people really talking. A lot of the Instagram models do it where they do certain videos or different photo shoots and it really gets people starts talking from there. People are really in tuned into what you got going on at that point. This is where knowing exactly what your competition is doing is very key, because usually when you have competition, there's people that are heads and shoulders leaders of or in front of what everybody else is doing. But usually those people are doing the most basic thing. They're just probably super consistent. So if you say, all right, this is what this photographer, this videographer, this chef, this author, so on and so forth are doing, how can I do what they're doing at this far as quality wise, take it to another level creatively? So this is where coming up with short films for different things come into play, or different video tricks come into play, or really it's just stepping up your quality and doing something supremely creative on a different level. So that is really the things that make the, what the fuck moment. Okay, my third choice would happen to be, once you create your what the fuck moment, you really have to start doing things on that consistent level, as far as quality as well as creative wise. You can't do this one piece of great content and then everything else after that is shit. You have to really just start putting in the work, say, all right, if I'm doing a short film, then my next short film has to be on another level. Or I can start creating many short films with stuff going on in the area, but it's still got the same quality, got people talking, the buzz factor has to be there, the what the fuck factor has to be there, just everything has to be on that certain level. A lot of people start creating and then they start to go down. What usually gets me thinking about this is back when internet wasn't really popping like that or whatever, that when music artists first dropped their first album, and then after that, their first album and people like really rock with their first album. Our example would be College Dropout with Kanye. He didn't have a lot of features before. He wasn't like buzzing really hard before, but when he dropped College Dropout, that put him on a different level. And then everything after that, as far as he had like a year where he would just do his features, get his features off, was on everything. He was killing everything around. So that kind of put him on another level. So with an entrepreneur or with being an entrepreneur or being a creative, once you drop that, I ain't gonna say magnus opus, but that high level piece of content, you have to follow that up with something along those same lines. Cause then it'll get people saying that, yo, you're just not a one trick pony, you're really here to stay. So that's it. Oh, also with that, you wanna make sure that, I ain't say oversaturate, but you make sure you have a strong presence in whatever industry that you have. People need to really start talking about you as like the next big person in your particular industry. So like, you definitely wanna be high, super consistent. Like at that point, you really need to start doing your posts. You need to start being at different venues. Depending on what you do, you just need to be visible to everybody around you, because that's really gonna get your name out there in the street. People gonna see your face. Then people gonna go back to your social media, or go back to whatever you're doing and really start following you. And then you can really start making some money off what you're doing. Also on top of that, with this particular one, once you start doing something on a high level, you're gonna see your competition pretty much jacking whatever you're saying, which is a good thing, but it's also a bad thing. So a lot of people get stuck in, God, they wasn't doing that before I was doing it. And then they wanna start doing these type of videos or these type of photos or so on and so forth. But that's gonna happen. You just gotta be aware of people are gonna jock something that people see gets a lot of traction. So you just gotta be very aware of that and don't let that discourage you, but just continue to put out. And that actually kind of leads into my next option. Create your second undeniable hit. And when I say that is usually a lot of creators, they start to go up and then they plateau for a while. They start to get a nice level of acclaim or recognition and then they plateau. And then this is where the people that are also coming up start to overtake you. Cause you have to realize that your fans, the people that support you, they are always into what's the next big thing. So when, shout out to my guy Rob Hill, when he starts taking off with his books and him just being consistent on like social media, Instagram, you then start to see a lot of other people start to come up and pretty much take the same concept, and then people start fucking with them a little bit more than they do the originator, just because they're somebody new, they're giving a new perspective, a new twist on what somebody else has already did. So you gotta definitely keep that in mind when you're creating. But then to stay ahead of that, to stay ahead of the plateau, stay ahead of the people that's on your trail, you have to create something, pretty much take your creativity to the next level. I was gonna say the second or third level, but the next level. And really just put out something else that kind of like blows them out the water. Then I feel like at that point, you really start to get traction as like pretty much the leader of that particular industry. Once again, I take it back to music. Whoever is hot, they usually have a good moment of Young M.A. We'll take Young M.A. for example. Young M.A. had a great first song, which it was an okay song in my personal opinion, but a lot of people fuck with the song. So she had a great first song. Then she'll put in our freestyles. The freestyle is dope. She could definitely spit. I might throw a clip of her spitting right here. But yeah, she put out a couple freestyles and then no second song. So people are like, yo, where the fuck is Young M.A.? Yo, I was like rocking with what she had going on. But then she just kind of just disappeared. Nobody seen her. She put a couple songs, but people didn't generate to it. Yeah, people didn't like flock to it. So now I have no idea what she's doing. But on the flip side, you have somebody like Cardi B who put out the same formula. She put out her first hit. And then she's starting to kill like the features, like No Limit feature, that Spanish song she got, the Motorsport, there's some other stuff, Bruno Mars song. And now she's putting out her next single, which is going to, people already starting to rock with it. It's starting to, you know, do numbers, and that's gonna be like her second hit. And so that kind of takes you out of like the one hit wonder lane and puts you in like the lane of this person is here to stay. That's what I mean. Like once you create your first hit, you flood the market and then you go to your next hit. And that has to be something, like I said, surpasses what you did before. So that's pretty much it. Like I said, I'm back to doing these a little bit more consistently. I got kind of complacent. I'll just say that. Once again, follow me everywhere, Shad Harris. Follow the Rebel Society. Go to subscribe to my YouTube. Make sure you like, subscribe, do all that good stuff. But once again, this is Shad Harris of the Rebel Society, and this is The Process.
Yeah, The Process. Make sure you subscribe right now on YouTube. And now go ahead and follow me on Instagram and Facebook like that too as well, okay? All right, bye.